Hey guys, what's up? Welcome back to another YouTube video. If you guys are new here, hi, my name is Purvi and this is my YouTube channel. So I would love if you would subscribe to my channel and ring the notification bell so that you never miss out on a video. With that being said, as you guys can see by today's title, I am doing a proper video as to how I achieve a flawless base for my makeup. This video has been requested on my Instagram for so long. And this has been in the talks. I wanted to make this ever since I started this YouTube channel, but I just couldn't get that far. So finally today, here I am. I am going to be talking about how I get my base so flawless. And I also asked you guys to give me some questions on Instagram regarding skin and base makeup. So I will be answering those on the way. So if you guys are ready, let's jump right into the video. Before getting into this video, I will let you guys know that I have a combination skin which is leaning towards dry. So what might work for me might not work for you, and things that might work for you might not work for me. So this is obviously just an advice for you guys. I'm not claiming that this will help you 100%. This has helped me a lot in getting my base really good, and I have picked on these things throughout the years of doing makeup. So it's my experience and I'm sharing it with you guys. It is not mandatory that it will work for you. So first, I like to prep my skin a lot because I have a dry skin, almost a dry skin. I have a combo skin. So I prep a lot. I do a lot of things with moisturizing. If you have oily skin, you need to be very specific with your moisturizer because you don't want oil infused moisturizers, because it will make your skin look more oily and hence your makeup will not look as flawless as you want it to. So for the dry skin girls, please go for very nice and moisturizing moisturizers. Try some options and select what suits you. And for the people with oily skin, you might want to test different types of moisturizers which are not infused with oil, because it will help your skin a lot. Okay, so for my skin, I use two products to moisturize my face. First one is the Mamaearth Skin Plumping Serum, face serum. I started using this I think 6 months ago and I have been hooked onto it ever since. This is very nice. It makes my skin look really dewy. It helps me get that dewy finish after I do my makeup, and protects my skin. So I use this first, and then I use the Pond's Light Moisturizer. This has been my ride or die for quite a few years now, and I love this moisturizer. There are others that are really sticky and oily that makes your skin look really oily, but this one is not like that. This dries down really nicely and moisturizes and basically does the work. So I'm gonna go ahead and moisturize my face with these two products. Also, quick disclaimer, I will have all the products that I'm using in this video listed down in the description below. So if I miss out something, it will be in the description. With the face plumping serum, I like to take a few drops and I tap it onto the skin first, and then I just massage it really nicely. It feels so good on the skin. It is a little tacky at first, but then it dries down very nicely and you can feel that your skin is moisturizing and it is getting hydrated. Yeah, look what glow it gives to your skin. Then I'm gonna take this one. I take very little bit of this moisturizer because a little goes a long way. So I take this much. After I applied my moisturizer, I let it sit for a minute to let my skin absorb it completely, and then I move in with the next step. Now that I've let my skin sit for a second and let it moisturize, it is now ready for some makeup to slap on it. So for the next step, I always prime. You need to prime to get that base flawless, because if you directly get it on your skin, first of all your skin will break out, because it is makeup, it has chemicals and it will break out. So priming is very important. One, to make your makeup long lasting. Two, to protect your skin, and three, to give your skin a texture. So first foremost, I am using the Nykaa Prep Me Up primer. You can use any primer that you feel comfortable with. I'm gonna use this one. I also used to use the Smashbox primer water to make my skin even more dewy because I do not like matte finishes on my face. But I have completely ran out of it, so we're not using this one. With primer, what you wanna do is take your fingertips and press it into your skin, nice and slow. Do not massage your skin with it, just press it into your skin with tapping motions. I mostly use primer on the areas where it gets oily and tends to crack. Okay, the primer is on, I have my skin protected. Next up, I go in with a dark shade of concealer because I have pigmentation. If you have no pigmentations on your face, you can completely skip this step. This is just for me because I have pigmentation here. I have literally two different shades on my face, so I have to do this. So I'm going to fast forward through this process and then we're going to jump into the actual process. Okay, so I have concealed my pigmentation and dark circles. I also went ahead and did my brows off camera. There's nothing too much about it. So I did it off camera. Now we're going to jump into foundation. For foundation, I like really full coverage. But if you don't, you can use any other foundation. I'm going to be using the Maybelline Superstay Foundation. It is in the shade 310 Sun Beige. Now I have a few questions related to foundation, which I will be answering during the process. So, and this is a little dry, and I think it is not really for my skin, but I really like this foundation and how it gives me the complete coverage that I need, and also it is so budget friendly. So what I do is I mix oil with that face oil. You can use a face serum or a face oil, whatever you like. But if you have oily skin, please do not mix oils with your foundation or on your face. I also sometimes like to put the oil directly on my face, but mostly I mix it with this foundation. One, I require less product when I use oils with it, and also it gives me a very dewy finish because I do not like matte finishes. But if you do like matte finish, this is the perfect coverage and foundation for you. One teeny tiny drop of this oil, that's it. I only use one drop, sometimes two drops, depends on how dry my skin is that day. So there are a few questions that I have related to foundation itself. The first and the most asked is how to select the right foundation shade. There is no correct answer for this according to me. It's a trial and error process, I think, according to me. You need to try a different foundations and maybe you'll get your right shade. But even if you don't, you can actually manage using different types of foundations. Because I have a light shade foundation for my skin which I used in the previous video. So if I'm using that foundation, I sometimes mix my own shade and then apply it on my face, see if it is working with me or not. Because I have three different shades on my skin. I have one that is my cheek, my forehead is different, my hands are super tan, my neck is not tan. So I have three different shades. So which color should I select? So I just go with what suits me the best. And I guess you can do that too. But while you're selecting a foundation, make sure that you select by swatching on your neck, on your chin, and on your arm. If you have tanned arms like me, don't do that. But if you do not, then you can do the three swatches and you will get a shade very close to your skin. Also, you need to check the lighting where you are while you're selecting your foundation because the lighting matters, because this foundation will look different under different lightings. So you need to make sure that the lighting that you are in is giving you a proper shade. So someone has asked me best foundation for perfect coverage for dry skin. So I do have a relatively dry skin and I use this foundation, but it is little matte and I use oils with it. But I am not really familiar with a lot of foundation. I have not used a lot of different foundations, so I don't think I can suggest you that. But I would again ask you to do the trial and error method, try different foundations. Maybe the Maybelline Fit Me one. It is very good, I think, for dry skin. I have used it a lot. It has low coverage, so if you're not a full coverage person, you can again use that one. It gives minimum coverage and also makes your skin look flawless. So yeah, you can. Next up we have concealer. So for concealer I'm going in with the Maybelline Fit Me Concealer in the shade Medium 25. I'm actually used to using the LA Girl Pro Conceal, that is my go-to, but I ran out of it and I could only grab my hands on this. So I got this. It is also a very good concealer. So what I do with my concealer is, I've already did the concealing with the darker one, so I use very little because this is only for brightening and not for concealing. So I use a little bit here on the corner and just drag this product without going in again towards the ends here. Again going in the corners. I just drag the same product. Then for highlighting my forehead, this is really optional. If you don't like highlighting your face, you can completely skip this step, but I love highlighting my face. It gives a really nice dimension to the face. So someone has asked me, is concealing necessary? No. If you don't want to conceal, it is completely up to you. I think I conceal because I need that brightening in the center of my face because it looks really fat. Wow. What I like to do is, I like to take this concealer on my lid too. I will be concealing my lid when I do my eyeshadow. I literally just disconnected. What the hell did just happen? Okay, so I like to drag this concealer on the lid too, whatever remaining I have, and blend it very nicely. So what this does is, it will brighten your skin and it will not make it look flat. See how flat this looks, but after you blend it, you have a very nice shadow and dimension to your face. But if you don't want that highlight, you can obviously skip this step completely, but I would recommend concealing. And for the question that someone asked me, is concealing necessary? No, obviously not. If you do not have dark circles, or you do not have pigmentation, you don't need that much coverage. Sometimes only foundation works for you. If you have very nice coverage foundation, it will look good. But also, if you are not a foundation person, if you don't want to use foundation, you can just use concealer. Like, only fill up these areas and just start blending throughout the face, and it will give you a very nice natural look, but still you'll be wearing makeup with a little bit of coverage. So I would actually recommend you using concealer instead of foundation if you want to pick only one thing, because I think concealer has better coverage and lasts longer. Okay, so the next question is, what's the difference between a foundation, a BB cream and a CC cream? So basically, a BB cream or a CC cream has SPF in it. It depends how much it will protect you from the sun. And also, I don't think BB cream and CC creams have as much coverage as foundations. There are a couple of foundations which have SPF in it, so you can use foundations with SPF if you want to sunblock your face. If you do want a little bit of coverage and protect yourself from the sun, but don't want to wear foundation because you think it's a little heavy for you, you can completely go for BB creams and CC creams, because I started with BB creams. I would actually recommend BB creams and CC creams too. But if you are a foundation person, there are a lot of foundations which have SPF in it, and it will help with sunblock. So yeah, that's my answer for that question. Okay, next up, I'm going to be powdering my face, setting it very nicely because I get no creases. So somebody actually asked me this question, how to avoid fine lines. So my number one suggestion would be, after you apply your foundation, after every cream product, you need to powder it so that you can set it. So I only use powder in these areas where I tend to crease, because if I put it all over my face, it looks a lot matte, which I don't like. So I only use here. So before going in with my powder, what I do is, I take my fingers and blend. If there are any creases, it will get blended in. Now whatever is left on the brush, I take it and I just go over my whole face with it, just to make sure everything is in place and not creased. I don't take extra product, I just take the brush, and whatever excess is left, I just go in with it. So a lot of people call this the base, but I also consider contour or bronzing. I do not contour, but I do bronze. So I'm gonna bronze up my face and also talk about a few more things. So bronzing, I'm using the Sugar Bronzer in the shade Woody Wonder 02. This is how it looks. I really love this bronzer. I love the color. I love the blendability of the product. And I love how it is perfect for my skin tone. So what I do is I just stamp it here at the very end to make the cheekbone effect. And then I just go like this. Swirl it on. Blush I'm using again. Sugar blush in Mauve Marvel. I love this shade. This is the base all complete, you guys. Yeah, this is how I do my base and I achieve that flawless finish. Of course, I'm gonna do my eyes and lips. And after that, setting spray is also very important to keep that base intact. So I would 100% recommend you guys to invest in a setting spray. Hey guys, so this is the completed look. As you guys can see that my base is as perfect as it can get, and you saw the process. Let me know what you thought about it. Hope you guys liked this video. If you did, please give this video a big thumbs up. Comment down below what you want to see next from me, and if you like these kind of videos, so I will keep making them. And if you haven't subscribed yet, please subscribe to my channel and ring the notification bell so that you never miss a video. With that being said, find me on my socials. Everything will be on the screen and in the description below. And I will see you guys in the next video. So until then, keep smiling, keep loving.